بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم أستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المؤمنين واستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي رب يسر ولا تعسر وتمم بالخير وبك نستعين يا فتاح يا فتاح يا فتاح صدق الله العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم الأمين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته
وعليكم السلام
الحمد لله It's a great blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he has given me and you the ability and tawfiq to participate in this gathering and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make this gathering a source of guidance for all of us and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make this gathering one of the means of our entry to Jannah Inshallah tonight with the ayah number 8 of Surah Al Imran I want to share with you some reflection, some really beautiful reflections of this very beautiful and powerful dua. And I chose this ayah. By the way, this ayah is ayah number 8 of Surah Al Imran, chapter number 3 and ayah number 8. And the reason I chose this ayah of all the ayat of Surah Al Imran is because I feel that the month of Ramadan is particularly very relevant. And a very good time to make this dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching us in this surah. And it's a beautiful dua. So what is that dua? Let's just try to understand this dua. So we say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rabbana, O our Rabb, O our Master, O our Lord, La tuzigh qulubana, don't let our hearts deviate. You know the word zaga in Arabic language, mashallah, many Arab brothers are sitting here. So whenever I speak about Arabic words, I'm always in fear, but probably they don't approve that meaning. But Alhamdulillah, I go through some kind of tafsir, some books of tafsir, and then I found out these meanings. So the word zaga in this dua, Rabbana la tuzigh, the word zaga, in Arabic language, it means something that curves slightly, and you don't even realize that it's curved, because it curves very slightly. So you don't realize that it's curved. So for example, in Arabic language, the grave digger is called za'igh. You know why he's called Zayr? Because a grave digger, he is supposed to dig a rectangle, right? He's supposed to dig a rectangle. But while he's digging the grave, it's really difficult for him to keep the track of a straight line. So by the time he comes out of the grave, by the time he digs the grave and he comes out of the grave, he sees that the line is not straight. It's like a C. It's bent. And because of that reason, he's called Zayr. And the za'il is also used for a person who is walking straight. But then he doesn't realize that he took a wrong turn and now he is deviated. So that person is also called za'il. So you say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, don't let my heart deviate. And by the way, deviation is not 90 degree angle. Deviation is not like you're going straight and then all of a sudden you start going this way. It's not like you're going this way and all of a sudden you start going this way and you don't even realize that you're going this way now. That's not deviation. Similarly, when your heart got closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you do something and your heart gets closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it does not get disconnected from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a split second. It doesn't. It inches away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala little by little by little by little. So that's why you say to Allah, Rabbana la tuzigh qulubana, Ya Allah, please put a protective measure in place which does not allow my heart to go away from you little by little by little without me even realizing that my heart is going away from you. Because after the month of Ramadan, we don't even realize that we have no sensation of Iman in us. We don't. Before we realize it, we don't have any sensation of Iman in us. You know, because, brothers, what happens is that in the month of Ramadan, all of us, alhamdulillah, we feel closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we haven't felt in a long time. In the month of Ramadan, we are in the mosque. We are praying all the time. We are surrounded by the people who are praying all the time. They are doing the zikr of Allah. They are making dua. And sometime when they make dua, they start crying. And we feel it so much that we turn to Allah. And we start making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then we start crying as well. And when we start crying, we start talking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We start acknowledging our mistakes, our shortcomings, our sins. And then we beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, forgive us. But at the same time, when we talk to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we also request Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, I wish I have this feeling all the time. And not just in the month of Ramadan. I wish I have this feeling all the time. When you say this to Allah, when you are making dua to Allah, and you say this to Allah, Ya Allah, I wish I have this feeling all the time. That's the time when you make this dua. رَبَّنَا لَا تُزِهْ قُلُوبَنَا. Oh Allah, don't allow my heart to deviate. Don't allow my heart to deviate. بَعْدَ إِذْ هَدَيْتَنَا. After you have guided us, very interesting language. Very interesting language if we only try to understand it. The first part of the dua, what are you saying to Allah? Ya Allah, don't let my heart deviate. So the first part of your dua is about your heart. But in the second part of the dua, you are saying, ba'da is hadaytana, after you have guided us. You're not even mentioning heart anymore. Logically speaking, the dua should be, oh Allah, don't allow my heart to deviate after you have guided my
heart.
But you're not saying this. What are you saying? You're saying, Ya Allah, don't let my heart deviate after you have guided us. So Mufassirin says, in other words, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling you that your entire being is your heart. Subhanallah. Your entire being is your heart. So if your heart is guided, your entire being is guided. And that's the exact same thing that we were talking about last night. The month of Ramadan, the purpose of the month of Ramadan is to train your heart so that your heart can control your body. So you say to Allah, رَبَّنَا لَا تُزِيقُ قُلُوبَنَا بَعْدَ إِذْ هَدَيْتَنَا. Oh Allah, don't allow our heart to deviate after you have guided us. وَهَبْ لَنَا مِنْ لَدُنْكَ رَحْمًا. Hiba in Arabic language, it means gift. It means gift. So the verb means to give a big gift, to give a huge gift, to give a massive gift. So you say to Allah, Ya Allah, give us the grand, give us the great, the generous gift of your mercy. وَهَبْ لَنَا مِنْ لَدُنْكَ رَحْمًا. The mercy that is coming specially from your secret world. Don't give us just some kind of mercy. Ya Allah, give us the grand gift of your mercy that's especially coming from your secret words. And I'm using this language very carefully here. Because the word ladun in Arabic language, it means that something that you possess secretly. Ladun doesn't mean that something that you possess, just there is something that you possess. No. Ladun means something that you possess which is in your private collection and no one else has ever seen it. When you take something out of your private collection and then you give it to someone, that's what we call ladun. Haza min ladunni. It's a special gift from me. Because if there's a pen here and you give that pen to someone, in Arabic language you will say haza min indi. This is from me. This is just a pen from me. But when the word ladun is used, it means that you are giving something really special to someone. It's really special. It's some special kind of mercy to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in other words, what are you saying to Allah? Listen to this carefully, especially my young brothers. Listen to this carefully. What are you saying to Allah? You are saying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that, Ya Allah, I have gone away from you. I have drifted away from you before. Time and time and time and time again, I have drifted away from you. I got closer to you and then I migrated away from you. I got closer to you, then I migrated away from you. I have been through this before so many times. And I know this is a cycle. And you know, when we are stuck in a cycle, we think that, you know, it's going to happen. It's going to happen anyway. This is typical. We can't do anything about it. There's nothing new about it. This cycle is going to happen anyway. We can't do anything about it. No. No. When you feel like this, make this dua. وَهَبْ لَنَا مِنْ لَدُنْكَ رَحْمًا. Ya Allah, you must have some special secret of your mercy that you possess in your secret vaults that you give me in this month of Ramadan. And because of that special mercy, Ya Allah, I will break this cycle. I will break this cycle and I will keep coming closer to you. And my heart will never go away from you. This dua is a dua of hope. It's a dua of mercy. You don't look at the track record of your past. And you don't say to yourself, Ya, whatever, I am terrible. And it's going to happen to me anyway. And I have been through this cycle so many times before in my life. Every single month of Ramadan, I get closer to Allah. And then after the month of Ramadan, I go away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No, no, no. You make this dua. وَهَبْ لَنَا مِنْ لَدُنْكَ رَحْمًا. Ya Allah, give me that secret weapon of your mercy that helps me to break this cycle. إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْوَهَابِ. Finally, إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْوَهَابِ. And Ya Allah, no doubt, you are Wahhab. Not even Al-Wahib. Subhanallah. The language is so beautiful here. You are Wahhab. Wahhab means someone who gives a lot of gifts. And he gave gifts repeatedly, over and over and over and over again. Ya Allah, indeed, you are one of those people who gives a lot of gifts, and you give repeatedly and continuously. So in other words, we are saying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, I don't need this gift only one time. No, I don't. For that to pull out, from you to pull out that secret world of your mercy, of your guidance, of your love, of straightening my heart, I don't need this only one time. Because I will need this tomorrow. I will need this again the day after tomorrow. I will need this again the day after tomorrow. So Ya Allah, I turn to you and I call you because you are Al-Wahhab. You give a lot of gifts and you give repeatedly and continuously. That's why Ya Allah, I'm calling you. I'm not turning towards anyone. I'm just turning towards you because you are the only one who's going to give a lot of gifts and who's going to give this gift repeatedly and continuously. What a beautiful dua. You know, every single month of Ramadan, because tonight is the last night of the month of Ramadan. And every single month of Ramadan, we say that after the month of Ramadan, the Ramadan fever comes off. Always we say this. But inshallah, if you memorize this dua, this is the dua which will help you to have the fever of Ramadan throughout your whole life, inshallah. Throughout the whole year. If you read this dua, you turn to Allah, sincerely you understand what you are saying in this dua, and then you say this dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will always feel the feeling of the month of Ramadan. Always. So let's say it again together, inshallah. Tonight is the last night of the month of Ramadan. So I will read and I will request all of you brothers kindly to read after me. And if you want to memorize this dua, this is the 8th ayah of Surah Ali Imran, verse number 8, chapter number 3. And a beautiful dua. And it's so relevant. And it's so good, especially in the month of Ramadan. So let's make this dua together. I will say, and all of you brothers who are sitting here, kindly you are requested to say after me.
ربنا
لا
تزغ
قلوبنا
بعد إذ
هديتنا
وهب لنا
من لدنك
رحمة
إنك
أنت
الوهاب. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants understanding. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those who become recipient of the love and mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah grant us this special weapon of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which help us to break the cycle. And we will keep coming closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and our heart will never go away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Barakallahu wa